Hello, my dear kids. How are you? Myself, Kokila teacher, and today I have brought some interesting subject for you all. In this subject, you all are going to have lot of fun and you are going to really enjoy the session. Any guess, children, which subject I am going to teach you today? Let me show you something. What you can see here, children? Yes, you can see rocket, kite, aeroplane, tree, fish, house, car. Yes, there are so many pictures here, isn't it? I hope you all must have understood which subject I am going to teach you today. Yes, I am going to teach today drawing. Yes, so before starting that, let me ask you a riddle. We will start with a riddle. Now tell me, I am something that goes up. I am something that goes up, although I am not a kite. Although I am not a kite, I am held over your head. I am held over your head to block rain or sunlight. To block rain or sunlight. Who am I? Yes, tell me, children. Yes, right. An umbrella. So today's topic is an umbrella. I am going to show you how to draw an umbrella. So let's start. Now here you can see I have drawn a margin line. Okay, that is, you can see four lines over there from all the four sides. That is known as margin line. Before starting your drawing, always you should start with the margin line. You should draw the margin line first and then you will draw the drawing. As you can see here, I have drawn the margin line and then I have written the heading. So what is our heading today? Yes, our heading is an umbrella. So now let's start. Here you can see I have drawn a slanting line. What I have drawn? A slanting line. Okay, you can see the line is gone from down to up. From down it is gone up. Okay, that is known as a slanting line. The next step is, I have drawn a semicircle on it. I have drawn a semicircle on it. Okay. So first we have drawn a slanting line and then you have drawn a semicircle. Now the next step. Here you can see I have drawn two parallel lines. I have drawn two parallel lines and then from down I have turned it and I made a handle. I have made a handle. Now in the next step, here you can see I have drawn small semicircles. What I have drawn? I have drawn small semicircles. You can see it? Yes. And up I have drawn a small triangle. What I have drawn? A small triangle. Now here you can see I have joined a line from up to the semicircle. From the top to the semicircle. Okay, I have drawn a curved line, you can see. I have drawn a curved line from top to the semicircle. Okay, I have joined all the semicircles and I have erased the slanting line. I have erased the slanting line. Here you can see we have finished drawing our umbrella. Yes, we have finished our umbrella. Now the next step is we are going to start coloring. We are going to start coloring. You can use two different colors or multicolor or one single color. It is up to you. It is up to you. Okay, it's your choice. Whether you want to use a single color, whether you want to use two alternate colors, okay, or a multicolor. Okay, so let's start our coloring part now. Here you can see I have used purple color and I have colored alternate. Okay, I have colored alternate and I have drawn the border. You can see the border I have colored it first. Why I have colored the border? Because so that when I am coloring inside, the colors will not go out of the line. So that the color will not go out of the line. Okay, so the next picture you can see I have used a blue color. Here I have used two different colors, that is purple and blue. I have used two different colors, that is purple and blue. And I have starting I have colored only the border of all the sides. Okay, here you can see I have colored first the purple side. I have used a purple color first. Okay, I have finished my purple and now I am going to use blue color. See, I have finished with my blue also. Now our handle and the top is remaining. Yes, here you can see I have used brown color for the handle and on top also I have used the same color. I have also made a small beads. I have shown a small beads on the tip of the umbrella. So here we have finished with our coloring part also. We have finished with our coloring part also. Okay, so one more time I'll show you from the beginning what exactly we have done. Okay, we will do a short revision. Okay, if you want you can pause this video and you can also draw. First you can draw a slanting line, then you will draw a semicircle on that. Okay, then two parallel lines and you will turn and make a handle. You will turn upwards and make a handle. Next is you will draw small semicircles, small semicircle, and on top also a small triangle you can show. Now you are going to join the upper top from top to bottom. That is, you are going to draw a curved line. You are going to draw a curved line from top to the bottom. Okay, see, I have joined all the semicircles over here. Okay, now the coloring part. First I have used purple color, which I have first only drawn the borders of it. I have colored only the border. And next I have used a blue color, the same I have first colored the border and then I have colored inside. Here you can see my colors have not gone out. It has not gone out. Yes, and then I have colored the handle with brown color and on top also. So here we have finished our coloring part also. Here we have finished our coloring part. Now here you can see, children, as we have finished with our coloring part, the picture is very, you can say it does not have any life at all. Yes, isn't it? It is looking very lifeless. Yes, so now we will show some raindrops. Okay, here I have used blue color for raindrops. Now after showing the raindrops, the background is very plain. It is very plain. You are not supposed to keep your background plain like this. You will always color your background with a light color. Why we are using light color background? So that the picture whatever we have drawn will be visible very clearly. If you use a dark color background, the picture will not be visible clearly. Okay, to make the picture visible clearly, we will use a light color background. So here I am using a light color background. I am using light yellow. Okay, so when we are coloring the background, you should remember that you will hold your crayons in such a way so that the coloring should look very neatly. Okay, if you are coloring the background in a standing direction, do you know what is a standing direction? Wait, I'll show you what is a standing direction. See, this is the standing direction. Okay, this is the standing direction. One more direction is there. Okay, that is sleeping direction. This is known as sleeping direction. Okay, this is known as standing direction. If you are holding your crayons in the standing direction, so you will color the whole background in the standing direction. If you are holding your crayons in the sleeping direction, then you will color it in the sleeping direction. Okay, you will not mix both the directions. It looks very untidy. You see, I'll just show you here. If I'm drawing like this and then like this, see how it looks very untidy, na? Yes. Now we have drawn an umbrella. So for umbrella, we will use only sleeping direction. Yes. So here, the next picture you can see, I have colored the background using light color and the direction is in the sleeping direction. See how nicely it is looking? Yes. If you want, I will make it more visible. See here. Isn't it? I hope you all have enjoyed this. You can also draw different types of umbrellas with different colors and different background. Yes. Once again, kids, I hope you all have enjoyed this session. So, thank you. Take care.